Children.
We'll see how it did last week.
Yes, did the same thing.
There's the other district, one of the other districts. Yeah, and then he's like, oh, I like the dress. Okay, I'll sit over here. I can see that over there. How are you guys? Come on up. Hello. Now you're ready to start running soon. How are you guys this week? Good? Anything exciting happen?
Yes.
What? Power washing? What was exciting? You mentioned church? Absolutely.
Yeah.
Anything else? Anybody do anything else that you thought God would go, that's pretty awesome. Something tomorrow. Go see your grandma. I bet she has missed you. I missed that, but I bet it was awesome. Alright, so this week, a great job, guys. So, tomorrow's my birthday, right? But, what you guys may not know is on Thursday is actually my 17th Christian birthday. So my Christian self starts to get a little older. Anybody know what a Christian birthday is? What that means?
What is it? My grandparents
trying to get their birthday presents. That's one idea. What were you gonna say? Maybe. So a Christian birthday. Stinky birthday? Well, I hope not. Not if there's a power washer. So a Christian birthday is when I accepted God to be my Savior. When I got baptized, we saw Bruce and William, their pictures when they were baptized. And that's when I said publicly that I wanted to follow Jesus and be a servant of Jesus, right? And all those things we learn about loving people and learning more, that's what mine is. So being 17, that means my Christian self basically had a license. That's a wild thought. So God tells us that we are to go out to all the nations and be a disciple. So my Christian self can now drive. That means I can drive all over the country and talk about God to people. I can even drive to Mexico City, right? In Mexico. Do you guys think you could be able to go on a big adventure and talk about Jesus to people? You think you'd be able to do that? Yeah? If you were to go on a trip, what are some things that you need? So let's say we went to Mexico. What would you need to go on a big road trip?
Yeah?
What would you need to take to go on a road trip?
A toy.
Say it again.
Toys.
What would you need to go on a road trip?
Snacks.
Yes.
And glow tape.
And
glow
tape?
Gloves.
That's so right.
And snugglies.
And snugglies, yes, because you would need to rest. We would need gas. We would need a mask. We would need snugglies, toys, food, right? All those things we would need. But could you imagine driving all the way to, like, California?
What?
That's a really long trip, right? Almost seems impossible.
And a Mickey Mouse
book. Exactly. See, all those things we would need, okay? But you know, one thing that God tells us is even though it seems like a really, really, really long trip, and a hard trip, and we may run out of snacks at times, may run out of gas at times, God tells us that he's with us in all of our adventures and all of our travels, and that we're never alone. So hopefully when you take a road trip, you're with your family and your friends. But no matter what, you get to go out and serve God on any adventure and any journey and any road trip. Does that sound good? All right. So do awesome things this week. I can't wait for you guys to get a visit with your grandparents. Tell them how much you love them and how excited you are to see them. Does anybody want to pray for us before we go on back? You want to pray back there? Okay, we're going to let her pray this time. Everybody close your eyes.
Amen.
Amen.